Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we are going to discuss a problem based on network diagram. Now this problem will cover drawing a network diagram and identifying a critical path. How to identify the critical path without calculating the floats, that we are going to learn today. Let's proceed. Problem number 7. The following table gives the activities in a construction project. So we have activities A to I, and then there are preceding activities, and then there is a duration. Till problem number 6, we didn't have the duration. Now from problem number 7, we have the duration. Duration can be in days, it can be in months, it can be in weeks, it can be in years, it can be in seconds. If nothing is given, we assume it is a time unit, which can be anything. Draw a critical path scheduling arrow diagram and indicate the critical path. What is the completion time of the project? So first we will focus on drawing the network diagram or the scheduling arrow diagram, and then we will learn how to identify the critical path, what exactly is the critical path, and how that helps to calculate the completion time of the project. We have activity A, and there is no preceding activity before A, which means A is the initial activity. Then after A we have B, after B we have C and D. So let's first draw till this point, till point number D. So I'll draw first activity A. So here is my activity A. After A, after completion of A, we can start with B, we can start with only B, and after completion of B, we can start with C and D. So A ke baad B aur B ke baad aapka aayega C aur D. So A ke baad B एंड बी के बाद आएगा आपका सी एंड डी. दिस इज सी, दिस इज डी. आफ्टर सी वी हैव ई, एंड आफ्टर डी वी हैव एफ. So after C, I will draw activity E. And after D, I have activity Now the next thing is we have only G after C. We have G after C, and we have to join E and F. So we have activity G, which I will draw upwards because I need to join E and F. So here is my G. I will again like to repeat, drawing a diagram is all trial and error. You need to practice, you need to draw in the rough format, and then only you will get a fair answer. So we have got A, we have got B, we have got C and D, we have got after C, we have got E and G, after C, we have got E and G, after D, I have got F. After D, I got F. Now I need to join E and F, and from E and F I will have H. So E and F needs to be joined, and from there I can work on H, and then I need to join G and H as well, so I can get I. So we need to draw the diagram again, because we need to join these two. We need to join E and F. So this need to be joined in this manner. So we'll draw a new diagram. Remember, friends, you need to draw this diagram with a pencil earlier, and then you need to draw the diagram, a fair one, once you get the rough one quite accurate. We'll join E and F here. From E and F I will get H. So we'll redraw the diagram. This is all from the perspective of a student. What problems a student face while drawing a network diagram. So this is my initial activity A. From A we have initial second activity after A is B. After B we have C, and we have D. After C we have E and G. So this is my E and G. From D we need to draw F, and we need to combine E and F to get H. So I will draw directly F. In my previous diagram this was drawn separately, so we had redrawn the diagram. Now after joining E and F I will get H, and again I need to join G and H to get I. So my H will be directly joined with G, and from G and H I will get I. So we are done with the diagram. We'll check once again the diagram. As usual, I always keep on urging the students to keep checking the diagram once they draw it, just to check the connections, because ultimately the whole problem depends upon drawing the network diagram accurately. If there is any mistake in the network diagram, it's almost certain that most of the part of your problem may go wrong. So we have A, after A we have B and C. After A we have B, after A we have B. After B we have C, after B we have D. So BK baad C, BK baad D. Then we have CK baad E, CK baad G. So CK baad G or CK baad E. Then we have E and F combined. E and F combined, and from there we do H, and after completion of G and H we have got I. So G and H are combined and we have got I. We'll name the nodes first and then we'll proceed further. So my nodes are 1, 2, 3. I'll name this as 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. I'll also note down the duration. I'll note down the duration with a red pen. No need to use a multiple pens in case of you as a student in the answer sheets. You can directly write with a single pen or a pencil. So for A it is 5, B 7. So A 5, B 7, C 2, D 3. C2, D3, E1, F2, E1, F2, then we have G1, H3 and I10, G1, H3 an item. So you are done with the diagram. We are done with the numbering. Now we are asked to find out the critical path. Now, and second thing, we are asked to find out the overall project completion time. So what is the completion time of the project? We asked two questions here. What, draw the critical path scheduling arrow diagram, and what is the completion time of the project, and we have to indicate the critical path. Now how this can be done? We will try to reach from the point of origin, that is the point of start, till the point of end, starting point till ending point, and we'll try to cover the different alternate routes on this diagram. What are my alternate routes? Alternate routes, and I got the duration here. My first route can be 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 7 and 7 to 8. See, I have to reach from 1 to 8. So what are the different ways in which I can reach? One is 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 7 and 7 to 8. So 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 7 and 7 to 8. What is the duration? 5 plus 7, 12. 14, 15 and 10. I am just adding all the durations of the various activities on this particular route. So it comes to 5, 12, 14, 15 and 10. It comes to 25. Next route I can follow here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8. Now the duration of this route is 5, 12, 14, 15, 18 plus 10, 28. I got one more route, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it is 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8. And the duration of this route will be 5 plus 7, 12. 12 plus 3, 15, plus 2, 17, plus 3, 20, plus 10. So out of all the three routes, we have calculated the duration of all the three routes. Out of this, the highest duration is of the route 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 5 to 6, 6 to 7 and 7 to 8. So I will say my critical path will be the activity with the highest duration. So in this case, my critical path is 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 5 to 6, 6 to 7 and 7 to 8. Which are the critical activities? Which are the critical activities? It is A, that is 1 to 2. 2 to 3 is B, 3 to 5 is D, 5 to 6 is F, 6 to 7 is H and I. And what is my overall project completion time? My overall project completion time will be the duration of the, so overall project completion time equals to the duration of the critical path. That will be my project completion time. So this was the way to identify the critical path and the critical activities and to find out the project completion time without calculating the floats. Thanks for watching this video. Do subscribe to our channel Ikeeda.